It owns the Wall Street Journal, Realtor.com, The Sun, The Times, HarperCollins, a seemingly endless amount of media properties. News Corp employs over 28,000 employees, and in 2020 made over $9 billion in revenue. It was founded by the notorious Rupert Murdoch. Murdoch's media empire and family have been an inspiration for the popular HBO TV series Succession. So what is it like to work at the real Waystar Royco, the actual news corporation, the media outlet that seeks to influence the way we see the world today? Here's what News Corp employees had to say on Glassdoor.com. Absolutely laughable company won't exist in a decade, predicts someone from marketing. Pros: absolutely nothing, none, nada, zilch. Cons: culture encourages mediocrity. C-suite is full of arrogant non-visionaries who are simply there to collect the check. Zero collaboration within departments. Okay, pretty standard so far for an aging company. Let's see what else is up there. Dreadful place. Pros: there were a few nice people in my department. Cons: there is a lot of hierarchy in this company, and it's very much got the cool kids. The building in Holt Street is dreadful. It's got an old newsroom 70s feel about it, and not in a good way. And there aren't even any plates or cups or anything in the kitchen. One would think a rupee could afford cups. Well, you don't get rich by buying people's cups, that's for sure. Advice to management: innovate. Former employee, more than 10 years experience, reconsider your need to work here. Pros: national reach, which may be worth working at for some seeking to gain experience, IT, or commission-based work, sales. Cons: lacks training or development. Talk the talk, don't walk the walk. Powers that be stick up a couple of posters in an attempt to create a sense of well-being being provided and raise the ever-dwindling staff morale, but don't truly and consistently support a cause, i.e. Are You Okay Day. Promote strong safety culture at the top, but at an operations level, safety is very lax and not consistent. Major cracks in workplace culture. At exit interview, I provided HR with a handful of instances where I had experienced vile, ongoing vilification of a sexual nature by my direct manager. HR rep response was, "We'll pass it on to the HR director." No interest shown by interviewer of the details, and an attempt was even made to belittle the complaint I was making by stating that the media tend to sensationalize these things when they report them. That's big, coming from a person who works at a mainstream media organization. Lacking direction company-wide, change enacted for the sake of change. Whole heaps of rats on the treadmill running over the top of each other. Advice to management: visit some other respectable Australian companies to learn how to treat your staff properly. Don't do it. Pros: I've met some serious talents during my time here. Unfortunately, their abilities have been hindered and silenced by the culture and management. Cons: severely outdated middle management. Won't touch an Excel sheet, as that's seen as junior's jobs. The team wouldn't be slash feel as lean as it did if upper management also didn't protect or shelter middle managers. No leadership, no guidance, no mentorship. Work is incredibly siloed. Non-existent HR department. Worked 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. during COVID. Run. Pros: great people and good location. Cons: lack of leadership and full of nepotism. Not willing to change their current ways and shuns employees who challenges the norm. Forget about career progression if you have an opinion about anything. Otherwise, make sure to say yes to everything. Constant restructuring and high turnover all across the business. Terrible business processes, old-fashioned thinking that will continue to bring more losses to the business. Don't work here or at the US Sun if you're a person of color or care about career advancement, advises a writer in New York. Pros: good health and retirement benefits, decent pay. Cons: everything else. Subtle racism, sexism, blatant favoritism, inept management, little to no room for career advancement, inconsistent schedule, lack of transparency, non-existent HR rep. Worked at the US Sun for 14 months, and it was easily the most toxic job I've ever had solely because of upper management. Editorial rules are a joke and selectively applied, and this is essentially a content farm masquerading as a glorified news outlet. Although editors say they encourage reporters pitching stories, that is, flagging articles from other websites to aggregate, what you actually end up doing is ripping stories straight from the Sun's competitor and pushing it as original. Unless you suck up to the editor, she won't ever acknowledge your hard work and blatantly shows favoritism to those who do. You'll never have a consistent schedule, and rules are selectively applied. integrity and work ethic isn't valued because incompetent and lazy employees are often rewarded before those with actual talent and skill. Editors don't value feedback on borderline racist headlines and consider pushing back as an insubordination despite them championing a collaborative environment. If you're a good employee, expect to have work piled onto you without so much as a thank you or promotion. You'll probably work longer hours than you're getting paid for. I, one of two black people on a team of 55, felt almost intentional that only about three people of color other than myself were hired since, none of whom were given full-time positions, and one who was fired at the end of 2020. The company tries to make it as difficult as possible for you to leave and didn't even give me my full paycheck, even though I did everything by the book. It's not worth working here for a paycheck. Better to take less money and go elsewhere to be respected and truly valued as an employee. I think the showrunners of the HBO show, I don't know if you've had a chance to check it out, did a pretty good job of capturing the spirit of News Corp, if that was their intention. Do you think these companies are going to survive in a technological age where media will eventually be run by the Googles and the Amazons? Let us know in the comment section, and as always, subscribe for more.